When I first came in to the recovery room immediately after surgery, I think her first words, as groggy as she was, I could hear. Nothing could have been better.
I was worried 2 years ago that I had an acoustic neuroma because my dad had an acoustic neuroma when I was a kid. I noticed some loss of hearing and I just thought I had an ear infection. But being a mom, I kind of ignored it and it would kind of come and go and then the ringing started.
So that's an unusual case to see a father-daughter pair with single-sided tumors. An acoustic neuroma, it's a benign growth of the balance nerve. It's very rare that they happen on the hearing nerve, but because they're so close to the hearing nerve, often the first symptom is hearing loss.
When I was 40 years old, I was diagnosed with an acoustic neuroma. I wound up with the same type of approach to surgery as my daughter Melissa, which was the middle fossa. There was a chance to save my hearing. Unfortunately for me, it was not saved.
Somebody having surgery for one of these tumors now is not facing the same risks that they were back 30 years ago. The fact that we have a team working together with a neurosurgeon and a neurotologist opens up a much larger variety of treatment options.
At UC San Diego Health, our primary goal is to save hearing when we can. Unfortunately, with acoustic neuroma, that's only possible for tumors in the neighborhood of 2 centimeters and less. Through microsurgery, we're able to remove the tumor completely and save hearing in as high as 85% of cases.
When I woke up post-op, the first thing they did was ask me to smile, and I felt myself smile, so I knew I had my facial nerve. And Dr. Friedman came by and kind of smoothed his fingers by my ear, and I realized I could hear his fingers. I felt very emotional and grateful.
We really have developed a patient-centered approach among the world's best operative and radiosurgical care, and also long-term post-operative. We love staying with these people and letting them know that we're here for them.
I know what it's like to live with somebody with hearing loss and how challenging that is. And the fact that I can be in a room and know where my family is a gift.